Hello, AC. Once again, I am Miss Maudy from the Campus Ministry Office, and I am here again for a short session of liturgical catechism as we observe the 500 years of Christianity in the Philippines. When we have our Masses of the Holy Spirit, we usually have the priests go around the congregation to bless us with the holy water. As Filipinos, we have come to associate the sprinkling of holy water with blessings. We ask priests to bless with holy water every nook and cranny of our houses, new stores, or businesses. Even our newly renovated classrooms or facilities are blessed before they are used so that they may be venues for us to encounter God. It is quite normal to ask priests to bless medals, cross pendants, rosaries, or palms during Palm Sunday. But have you heard that some even ask for holy water to be sprinkled on new cars, sports items, and even ball pens for taking exams, believing that it will bring them good luck? This is how much we Filipinos put stock on the efficacy of blessings, as if these items are suddenly magical enough to protect us from bad luck. However, the real object of blessings are not the items being blessed, but those who will receive or use them, that they may be brought closer to God through these blessed items. But now that there are no mass gatherings and holy water is not sprinkled on us during the Mass of the Holy Spirit, does that mean that we don't receive the blessing? The presence of holy water does not make the blessing. What makes a blessing efficacious or operational are the words uttered in prayer. So, even if there is no holy water, we can receive a blessing. Even if there is no priest, we can also bless by virtue of our priestly call as baptized Christians. Remember, we say God bless to one another. These words have power when uttered with sincerity and faith. When the priest tells us to bow our heads to receive God's blessing, listen to the words that he prays. They are not simply sentences that we answer mutteringly with an amen. They are sincere prayers for graces that we need, so that we may experience the fullness of life we are called to live. And we answer with a resounding Amen, because we earnestly desire these graces. May the blessings we receive help us become men and women fully alive, glorifying God by our lives.